Welcome at Bits of Blockchain. In today's episode, I'm going to explain the basics of tokenization. What is tokenization? What are the use cases? Let's have a look. To understand the basics of tokenization, it is good to understand the basics of blockchain technology. And in one of the previous videos, I gave an introduction to blockchain technologies. This is the video, and if you don't understand quite what blockchain is, I suggest to follow that video. And in that video, I explained, for example, that if you send a photo from a smartphone to someone else via the internet, the other party receives an exact copy of that specific photo. But you also keep the original. So there are two exact copies, and either of the party can send multiple copies to someone else. So everything on the internet is copied, because the same is happening to a WhatsApp message, an email, a spreadsheet, a document that we send. Everything is copied across the internet. And that is the whole reason we cannot send money via the internet without the use of an intermediary like a bank. But with the origin of the Bitcoin, the first blockchain network we worked, it is possible to send from one person to another person peer-to-peer cash without the need of a bank or institution. So what we actually can say is what the internet is for information, the blockchain is for value, and that's something. So what are the specific properties of the blockchain? In the first place, it is based on a ledger, and it's a distributed ledger, as we explained in the video. There's no central authority or controlling system like a bank or a government or a company. Also, everything we store in the blockchain is permanent, it's immutable, so it's a safe and guaranteed storage of digital value, and we can also transfer this digital value. It is providing trust, and it's transparent. Everyone, you don't need to be a member or a party that sends transaction. Everyone with a browser can look into a blockchain explorer and see all the transactions ever done on that specific blockchain, with the provenance, tracking it back, and see what's currently happening. It's very transparent. And also, we saw that if we don't not only put transactions into the blocks, but if we put computer code into the blocks, we can create smart contracts. For example, programmable money, and that is what we call smart contracts. If you talk about ledgers, we see that companies and institutions use ledgers to record business activity. You can use ledgers to track the transfer of assets. And also, each market defines its own ledgers because each market has specific properties, like the market for art, for real estate, in pharmacy, in money, food, fashion. There are many different markets, there are many different types of ledgers. Talking about coins and tokens, we see often the term alt tokens, alternative tokens. And these tokens are an alternative to the first blockchain, the Bitcoin. So the Bitcoin has its own blockchain network, its own blockchain platform. And these alt tokens also have their own blockchain platforms, often a fork from the Bitcoin code because it's open source, but it can also be a code built up from zero, from scratch, or an alternative to Bitcoin with specific properties like Ethereum, the second largest blockchain, or Cardano or Tron or others. Tokens, on the other hand, are they don't have their own blockchain. They live on top of another blockchain, and one of the blockchains that is carrying a lot of tokens is Ethereum. But also others do this, like Cardano, it's a runner-up. There you can create your own token by implementing smart contracts. So tokenization is representing a asset by a token. And if you go to a festival or a pop concert, you can buy tokens in order to get drinks. with the machines behind me. So you can put in there your credit card, buy a number of tokens, and these tokens you can exchange at the bar, for example, for a drink or a glass of beer. The golden coin represents a glass of cola, for example, and the blue coin, a glass of beer. And that is done because if I put the credit card, I show the credit card at the bar, they need to do a transaction, check if it is valid, it takes time, or if I pay with cash, they need to find the exact amount of cash to give me back. So it takes a lot of time and effort to process the transaction. So giving a token is much more efficient, and that's why they use this concept at events. And tokenization is basically based on the same concept. Tokenization is the process of representing an asset as a digital token that can be stored, tracked, and transferred on a blockchain. And also, the token can include metadata, since it is a digital token, it can include metadata like the ownership, provenance, certification, and when applicable, the history of processes. And it represents an asset, and there are different types of assets. For example, intangible assets like software, intellectual properties, or patents. You cannot touch it, but it's certainly an asset. Also, fungible assets, a liter of water, but also think of the glass of cola that you can get on the bar. It can represent a glass of cola, but it is not important if it is the left or the right side cola. You want the glass of cola, so it's fungible. And the non-fungible assets are, for example, artworks or real estates. You cannot replace just an artwork with some other artwork, or your house with the house of the neighbors. Although it might look the same house, it is different and doesn't carry exactly the same value. So an example for tokenization. Assume we have here a very valuable painting. I made it some years ago. It's not representing 1 million euro value, but in this use case, I like to do that. And 1 million euro in the trunk of my car looks something like this. It's not in the trunk of my car, but it's a lot of banknotes. And it's, not easy and not safe to carry it with you to buy or to sell a artwork. So what you can do is representing the asset, in this case, the artwork, with one token. And then the token carries the value of 1 million euro. So the token you can store in a secure wallet and transfer it like a Bitcoin. So with the transfer of the token, you transfer the ownership of the artwork. But if you can make one token, you can also create 5 tokens for the same artwork. And every token, every one of the 5, represent a value of 200,000 euro, together 1 million euro. So this means that every token, or the tokens together, represent the total ownership. There is a fractional ownership. 5 individuals can own together the artwork or the asset. The same way as we can own together via shares a company as a shareholder. So tokenization allows fractional ownership. And I can make, of course, more fractions, more tokens, say 5,000 tokens of 200 euro each. And then I can find more individuals who are able to pay 200 euro to own a fraction of the artwork and with that finance the artwork. So ownership can be distributed via tokens. Fractional ownership doesn't need to be done. You can create one token, but you can distribute it, fractional ownership. And it offers a unique way of sharing ownership of unique objects. So this is more or less the basics of tokenization. Thank you for watching this video. In the next episode, I will go deeper into the tokenization of art with a specific use case. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below and we will address them as soon as possible. See you soon.